Once again, a very good morning to you. Northwest Premier Supra Mamabelo has told the South African Public Broadcaster that he has voluntarily decided to resign. His resignation follows his announcement on Wednesday that he will inform the Speaker of the Provincial Legislature by Friday. Mamabelo has been under pressure to step down in recent weeks. Protest action over service delivery escalated into calls for him to quit. The National Office Bearers of the ruling ANC had to step in. Acting Provincial Secretary Suzanne Janki confirmed in a statement that the party accepts Mamabelo's resignation with a sense of apprehension, but great pride.
Tomorrow, I have convened a press conference. In the morning, 8 o'clock, I'll be meeting with the executive of the province. As soon as I'm done with the executive of the province, I'll be addressing the top management of the government in the Premier's office, after which I will be in a press conference to indicate the way forward beyond what I explained today. I think people did not understand me today because maybe the way I put the expression was such that people did not understand it. But what I meant was that we are already beyond what people are thinking. This thing of resignation, we are beyond that already. So tomorrow I'll just be explaining beyond this resignation, what is going to happen going forward. So we are no longer speculating on whether there's a resignation or not. We are beyond that. In the last meeting of the National Executive Committee, in the presence of former President Jacob Zuma, and in the presence of the current President Cyril Ramaphosa, I stood up and indicated to the meeting, as I say, in the presence of President Zuma, former President, and I said, I have never met with President Zuma in my life. When I meet President Zuma, I will not hide it because there's no reason for me to be meeting with him in secret, in private. He's still a member of the ANC in good standing. He's a leader of the African National Congress in his own right. He's a former president of the African National Congress. And I'm one of the people who believe that President Zuma, former, remains innocent until proven otherwise by due processes of the law. Unfortunately, in South Africa, we create particular narratives, and those narratives are meant to drive particular political agendas, and we find people guilty, even if before they go through those due processes of the law. It's unfortunate that those are the narratives we have created in South Africa. I don't need to hide when I meet President Zuma or when I meet the current president, President Ramaphosa. There's nothing illegal that we are doing and nothing that is against what the ANC stands for.
Well, the Democratic Alliance in the Northwest has reacted to the news.
If you look at J.B. Marks with Ventersdorp in terms of the amalgamation, that was a move to secure actually power for them. And another threat for them is Rustenburg and Gatling River, where they also now attempt to have these two municipalities together. And also with the EFF as a role player in the Northwest, I think that the ANC is really in for a high jump. We believe that people are going to the voting booths now with their minds, and they are open-minded, and we believe that they will do the right thing this time around.
EFF Northwest leader Betty Diale had this to say.
We definitely welcome the decision. We await the official resignation from the Premier. We feel that the decision and actual resignation is long overdue, but however, we will welcome it as a significant progress towards stability within the province. We actually foresee the possibility of Supra fighting back even against the potential candidate or the potential Premier acting that they will be putting as the ANC. The EFF in the province is very stable. The EFF will take advantage of the situation that is happening because we know Supra as he is. The one thing that must be clear is that Supra can be more powerful than the people of Northwest. The people of Northwest have shown him that he can be more powerful than them. They possess the power of their province.
Right, well, political analyst Professor Erwin Schweller weighed in on Mamabelo's resignation.
It has been a long-standing conflict within the province, and it's a conflict between different parts or political parties never like to be told that they have factions, but there are factions in all political parties, and in this case, factions in the ANC, both at national level as well as in the provincial level. And not only that, we've seen that this has played out into a lot of violent protests in the streets and towns of the Northwest Province. So that means that there's a lot of political pressure building up. And Mr. Maumapele did not initially indicate that he would even consider resigning. However, as these pressures have gained, the dynamics have changed, and now there is a serious and strong indication that he will resign.
We also spoke to our reporter in the Northwest, for World Views, Natasha Piri, on the issue on the ground in Mahikeng.
One thing that's also interesting, I mean, in their statement that they released yesterday, saying that the ANC in Bokoni Bophirima actually, you know, somewhat, you know, welcomes his resignation, but also says that they believe in his innocence, somewhat also insinuating that only a court of law could actually prove whether he's guilty or not, but they somewhat support him. But also, this is also interesting, the fact that when speaking to, you know, the likes of the Revolutionary Council, and of course, you also know that the National Working Committee had actually somewhat recommended to the NEC that the entire PEC of the province be dissolved. And this, of course, is where we actually get to, you know, the whole point of the two centers of power. I mean, if Premier Supra Mahumapelo steps down as premier, doesn't mean that he'll be stepping down as, you know, the ANC chairman.